Arizona Wildcats are trying to become the first team since Duke in 91-92 to repeat as national champions. But standing in their way, a very physical Utah Utes team. Joining me now, my partner, John Sunvold. And John, when you talk about Utah, you have to talk about their dynamic 6'11 senior Michael Doliak. He's got the intangible.
Well, Gus, you mentioned 6'11, but he doesn't always play that big. And what I mean is, he'll go inside like any other big guy. They'll lob to him, they'll throw it to him on the post, and he'll make those shots. But what he does best of all, he runs the floor. He's got great hands, he catches. He'll come off screens and knock in jump shots the other night, 25 points. 13 of 14 from the foul line. He is the reason why they're here this afternoon.
But Arizona, they've got two of the best guards in the country, Mike Bibby and Miles Stein.
Well, two first-team All-Americans. Take your pick which one you want. Arizona has both of them. Mike Bibby, explosive first half. He had 18 the first half, 25 overall. He had 5 of 6 three-pointers. Dynamic. He was passing, he was stealing. He did it the whole ball game long. Miles Simon, he waited till they needed it in crunch time. Late in the ball game, took over. His mid-range game is excellent. Either one, dynamic duo, first team All-American.
Arizona, Utah, their last meeting last year right here in Anaheim, where Arizona had to come back to win it. Coming up, the starting lineup. And welcome back to the Arrowhead Pond in Anaheim, California, the West Regional Championship game. Utah seeded third, Arizona the defending national champions. They are the number one seed. And for Arizona, they beat fourth seeded Maryland 87-79 on Thursday. All five Arizona starters in double figures. And the third member of our team joining us today, Armin Kazan.
Rick, excuse me. You said before the game you were contemplating something very dramatic. Are you going to do it? What is it?
Well, I don't know about dramatic. I mean, we got to take Bibby out of the game, so we're going to try to pay some special attention to him and maybe put a box of one, a little triangle and two on him and see how that reacts. I don't know if it's dramatic. It's we've gotten here with good man-to-man. I skeptical how much I should deviate from that, but I also realize that we have a severe matchup problem relative to quickness here.
What do you tell the team before the game?
Defend and rebound. It's a determinant factor in a winning championships, and then take care of the ball.
Thanks, Rick. Back to you, guys.
All right, Armin. So it's Arizona and Utah for a trip to San Antonio, and the Final Four coming up. We'll tip this one off from Anaheim. We'll advance to the Final Four. For the Utah Utes, Hanno Metsola and Drew Hansen, they have to hit perimeter shots for Utah to win this basketball game today. And they are coached by Rick Majerus, 50 years old, in his ninth season, looking for his first trip into the Final Four. The Arizona Wildcats, Mike Bibby, Miles Simon, the great backcourt combination, but Michael Dickerson, he's a third guard, along with Davison and Bramlett. And Lute Olson, his 15th season at Arizona, won the national championship last year, and he is trying for his fifth trip to the Final Four. Today's officials, Gerald Boudreau, Tony Green, and Tom Rucker. Utah leads the series 27-18, but their last meeting right here in Anaheim, California, in the Wooden Classic, Arizona had to come back, and they won it 69-61.
Gus, interesting ball game. Arizona, the third leading scoring team in the nation at 92 points a game. Utah defensively, they're fourth rated. Only give up 56. Something has to give, but it's not easy to contain Arizona. They have only had four games where they've scored in the 70s. No games in the 60s.
Utah advanced to the West Regional Championship with a 65-62 win over West Virginia. Michael Doliak, 25 points, 9 rebounds. Andre Miller, he had 14 points and 8 assists. So here we go for all the marbles out west and a trip to San Antonio, and we're underway.
Well, Rick Majerus said they'll pay a special attention to Mike Bibby. We'll see how they play him. They are a man-to-man ball club right now. They're in a triangle in two. They are shadowing Miles Simon, and they will shadow Michael Bickerson.
Dickerson off the dribble, pull-up 15-footer, and it's rebounded by Miller.
Arizona will open up in their man-to-man. We'll see the matchup of Bramlett on Doliak.
Metsola from Helsinki, Finland. In traffic, got it up. Bibby the other way.
Utah must get back defensively. They did on that possession. They have to continue to do that all ball game.
Al Simon, good defense by Hansen, and it's ripped down by Methala.
You can see the pace early, though. Arizona wants to push, get a good look. Utah content on walking it up the floor, getting a good look. Let's see if their spacing is good so Doliak can go to work down low.
Off over dribble, Miller inside, changes shot, and baked it in.
The spacing allowed Miller to go one-on-one.
And the Utes strike first blood. They go up 2-0, 18-37 in the first half.
Again, the triangle is three guys playing a zone. The man-to-man is against Bibby and Simon. 0-for-3 already the Wildcats.
Miller the other way. Doliak ceiling. Knocked out of bounds, and we stay right here.
As we saw with Thursday night, Doliak, one of the best running big men in the country, down low, got to the block early. They lost it out of bounds, so they'll retain possession.
Michael Doliak, senior from Portland, 6'11", academic All-American as well, 3.4 in biology.
You can see Bramlett out crowding Doliak because he's such a good perimeter shooter, they'll want him to put it on the floor.
Miller. The dribble. So here's Mike Bibby into the front court. How do you break a triangle at one?
Triangle and two, the fact that you have to set some screens, Dickerson becomes very valuable. Now Utah will go straight man to man. When they miss a shot, they've gone back to their man defense.
Bramlett forced it up. And it's recovered by Simon.
This is a very big and physical Utah team, the best rebounding team in college basketball. Their rebound margin is nearly 11 a ball game. They only allow usually one shot on a trip down.
Arizona 0-for-4. Bibby around the corner, forced it up, and he's fouled.
Well, the quickness of Mike Bibby on his first step. You have to be able to contain him, but what we saw the other night, he hit 5 3-pointers. He's deadly, so you get close to him, he goes by you.
Michael Bibby, sophomore from Phoenix, Arizona, had his wisdom tooth pulled on Monday. Was in the weight room later on that night. Simon baseline jumper blocked by Doliak into the hands of Miller.
Great save by Miller. Great block by Doliak.
Methala trying to post up Davison.
Utah's going to try to be physical when they set screens.
Gets into the hole. Got his own rebound. Bump. Put it up again. Tapped it up again. And finally cleared by Bramlett and a foul.
Opportunities early for Utah. You have to take advantage. When you're a lower seed, when opportunities come, these kind of games you have to finish. He misses once. Now he has an opportunity to get that ball back in the basket. You have to be able to finish these.
Alex Jensen, sophomore from Centerville, Utah, spoke to him before the game. He said, I got to hit a couple of shots and get my confidence going.
He thought he was tentative in the game Thursday, and it showed with his outside shooting. Nice entry pass by Miles Simon.
And A.J. Bramlett, not tentative at all. He banks it in. He had 11 points, 5 rebounds against Maryland. And we're tied at 2. But a good slowdown pace right now for the Utes.
And you can see offensively, they have 4 guys on the outside. They'll let Doliak go to work on the box again. The spacing is important. Arizona's a very good weak side help defense.
Methala. Bibby the other way. In transition.
Good job by Methala containing Bibby.
Simon, ball fake, busts it up. Wise play. He draws the foul.
Arizona good enough at sharing the basketball. Bramlett will get himself reset in. There was a mismatch down low. Miller got switched off. Good recognition by Miles Simon to put it back inside to the big man.
So Miles Simon, the most valuable player of the Final Four last year. Senior from Fullerton, California, at 18 points against Maryland, and the first free throw is good.
Simon, who comes up with big nights on big ball games. Does his best when needed. The other night it got to be a 1-point ball game on Thursday. He took over, hit a couple runners through the lane and a couple 3-pointers.
There's his dad, Walt. Looking on. Now Simon, second one off the front of the rim. Jensen with the rebound. Jordy McTavish, David Jackson inserted into the backcourt for Utah.
And Rick Majerus will do this because he doesn't want his defenders to wear down against the quicker Wildcats.
Jackson pops out. Sophomore for Portland, Oregon. Metzala around the screen. Great ball fake. And it's taken away.
With the help by this Wildcat defensive team. Outstanding.
Simon. And he throws it out of bounds. 15:45 to go in the first half of play. 3-2 Arizona.
Wildcats with a 3-2 early lead. And defensively, talk about Arizona. They're not big, but they're quick. Watch defense. Here's the fake by Metzala. Right when he puts it on the floor, we're going to see help here. Here from the top, we're going to see five Wildcat jerseys. They're not big, but they're quick. The help defense interior. There's a knockaway. There's a steal. That is why they're good on the defensive end.
Microsoft Databank, Mike Bibby, is the son of Henry Bibby, the former UCLA standout and New York Knick. Each year, Henry or Mike, that they've played college varsity basketball, their team has won a national championship.
Amazing stat. Henry Bibby, as a freshman, did not allow to play. What a solid screen by Doliak on Bibby at half court.
McTavish cannot make a play. Each team a little tight to begin this one. Utah 1 of 7. And Arizona 1 of 6.
Arizona off to a slow start. They forced a couple jump shots. Utah has to take advantage of this early weakness by Arizona.
A.J. Bramlett taking it right at Michael Doliak. Makes it a 5-2 game. Metzala, Doliak, inside, off the glass, and a whistle.
Anytime you're a point guard playing defense, you want someone to call out the screen. Mike Bibby can get hurt that way. A lot of times you get a shoulder bruise or something. He'll have words with his big man when he goes back.
So Michael Doliak at the free throw line had 25 points against West Virginia and was sensational from the stripe.
Yeah, 13 of 14 from the foul line. He hit the big ones down the stretch when they needed to. 81% free throw shooter on the year.
Andre Miller back into the basketball game. And the second free throw by Doliak is good.
We'll see after the made free throw what defense now Rick Majerus is going back to. Back to the triangle and two again. They will shadow Bibby and shadow Simon. Dickerson now has to become available.
Simon cross court. Dickerson rise and fire. And it grazes the front of the rim.
Couldn't tell if that was partially blocked by Doliak or not. They ran a nice set play.
Arizona 2 of 8. Miller. Rich Johnson, the freshman, into the game for the Utes.
And Johnson very good with the basketball off the dribble.
Miller on the box. Jackson let it go. Came up short. Out of bounds, we head the other way.
Jackson has to be ready to shoot it, Gus. When he first caught that ball, get ready to unload it. You don't get many opportunities or good looks.
So neither team shooting well. 1 of 8 shooting for Utah, 2 of 8 shooting for Arizona. Approaching the 14-minute mark.
Again, Dickerson will find shots against this triangle and two defense.
15 to shoot, Bramlett. Snatch down, Davison in traffic. Can't get it to go. And finally, Jensen comes up with the board.
And Doliak, first man down, he's on the block.
Jensen already has 5 rebounds.
If Doliak's fronted, they have to clear out the backside so they can throw over the top of this Wildcat defense.
Rick Johnson, the freshman, at 7 points against West Virginia. 14 to shoot. Jackson. Inside Doliak. Great position. Hit it and the foul.
Great position. Great pass. Alex Jensen right on the money.
And watch the patience of Utah on offense.
Continuing to try to find the big fella. Look at him lock himself. Bramlett can't get around the big body. The pass right on the money. Away from the defender. Easy basket for the Utes. Good pass.
Michael Doliak with 4 points. Foul committed on Bramlett, his second. with 13-19 to go in the first half.
Not a real deep team, but deep enough. Edgerson and Harris do a nice job when they come in the ballgame. Their defenders and rebounders played outstanding, both of them, in last year's Final Four.
They're in right now, along with Simon Bibby and Jason Terry, another one of those great guards.
Terry will try to take advantage of this triangle to himself.
Bibby, bad shot. Goliak with the rebound.
Bibby's worried about trying to get too much contact. Just has to go up and release his shot, Gus.
So it's working so far for Utah. Miles Simon probably needs to step up for Arizona. He usually does when they need it. And a whistle and foul on the floor. Mike Bibby, 0-for-2 from the field to start this game.
Against that triangle, too, Gus, if you take Simon down low and set a pick with a big guy on his defender, because he's playing he's being played man-to-man, and all of a sudden they have to switch. Now you have a big guy on Simon. He can probably break him off the dribble, causes mismatch, and they have to help. He could maybe have some dump-offs inside.
12:44 to go. Trace Caton into the game, to the basket, and he shuffled his feet.
Utah looks better, though, than they did Thursday night. They look more aggressive with the ball. They haven't shot well, though, but they're attacking the glass much better than Thursday.
12:38 to go. 7-5 Utah leading Arizona. They're the number 3 seed. And in the corner, Jason Terry answers.
As he came in for Dickerson, he's the one that will be available against the triangle, too. Terry, an explosive score, did not hit a point. Against what Thursday night in that ball game?
Against Maryland, Terry, a junior from Seattle. Jackson thinking about it. 13 on the clock. Methala to the basket, strong, off the glass, and he gets the roll.
Without Goliak, Methala and Johnson have to be the offensive threats.
Anno Methala. A sophomore from Helsinki, inside, out of bounds, and Arizona turns it over. 11:48 to go in the first half of play. Utah playing with the defending national champs. They lead it by a point.
This is Armand Katane. I'm down here at courtside where it's 9-8 Utah. You know, Rick Majerus has one of the best basketball minds in the business, but he's not above getting some help from his friends. In this case, George Karl, the head coach of the Seattle Supersonics. We saw them together on Thursday night, and they were having dinner diagramming plays, and I'm sure some of those plays are showing up on the court right now.
Well, interesting. In fact, George Karl, a great North Carolina player, they did draw plays, as coaches will do that. It's hard to implement things at this point in the season, but the triangle and two defensively has been really effective.
Rick Johnson. Over the half-court line, almost lost it.
Five seconds
if he doesn't get rid of it. Andre Miller to the basket. The runner is good.
Terrific basket by Utah, and the fact that Arizona had them scrambling. The first time we've seen the full-court pressure by this Wildcat team.
All 11 Utah points coming inside. They lead 11-8. Terry cross court, the lob, Eggerson, good grab, push, got it away, no whistle. It squirts out, Eggerson diving with Jackson, and finally, Britt Johnson with the ball.
Wildcats appear to be a little bit rattled about the triangle and two defense.
Ball knocked out of bounds by Bibby.
Last time down, Arizona finally put some pressure on Utah. They got a break. They caught the basketball, didn't get the five-second count, and Andre Miller delivers.
So Michael Goliak back into the game with Jensen, Methala, and Jackson, and Miller in the backcourt for Utah. Leading it 11-8.
Amazing, they've been able to control the pace even without hitting a lot of shots early in this game.
Miller for three. And finally, the Wildcats trying to run. Terry got the step on the baseline, lost it out of bounds. Third turnover for Arizona.
No easy baskets, no easy looks so far for Arizona.
So when you're a running team and you haven't been able to run, how do you get it going?
Well, you become frustrated a little bit. You can see the frustration on the faces. And when they get in the half-court set, it's taken about 10 seconds to figure out the triangle and two and what they want to do with it.
Miller, pull-up jumper. Terry with the board. Quickly into the front court, Dickerson. Simon flashes, dumps it down, stolen away by Miller. The junior from L.A. into the front court, Jensen, double bucket, counted, and the foul. So we are seeing a different Utah team today.
Much more aggressive. It starts on the defensive end. Watch Simon leave his feet. Terrific read by Miller. And then the push. They will take something if it's there. The hit ahead. Look at the strength of the basket. The finish. Utes off to a good start, even though they're not shooting a very good percentage.
Alex Jensen at the line. Missed the free throw. Tap back out, though, and Utah recovers. 9:54 to go. 13-8. Utes. Jackson. And a foul over the back on Metala.
You don't mind that aggressiveness, though. They're attacking the offensive boards. They're now 5 of 15 from the field. But they are out-rebounded Arizona 11 to 10.
Jason Terry, Harris, Dickerson, Davison, and Simon on the floor.
Again, Michael Dickerson becomes so valuable against this triangle and two. You're basically playing three on three. Three guys playing his own defense, three guys attacking him. Dickerson misses again.
And Michael Dickerson, remember, he had the tough final four, 2 of 18. Worked on his defense, though. Miller off the glass and in. The ball is rolling the right way today for Utah on an 8-0 run. Davison. Terry spinning. Dickerson. And an air ball. 15-8. And we have a surprise here in the West.
Well, you mentioned Michael Dickerson a year ago. 2 of 18 in the final four. He struggled shooting the ball. They need him today because they're just trying to contain Simon and Bibby.
Doliak, jump stop. Let it go. And it's rebounded by Dickerson.
Arizona now has to back up and regroup a little bit, Gus.
Simon from downtown.
They got fouled.
Jackson got a hand on it.
Simon not happy talking to the official when he let it go. His arm was pushed straight to the left. Caused that ball to veer.
8:13 remaining. 15-8. That's a lot. Jackson wraps around Miller. Double pump, got it away.
Miller's a point guard, but not a small one. 6'2", 200 pounds, he got it inside. Andre Miller trying to take over and take charge. The weak side cut, look at the pass by Jackson. Again, 6'2", 200 pounds, he's physical enough. The ball fake and the kiss off the glass.
Miller with 8 points. The Academic All-Stars recognize one player on each team for academic excellence. For today's game, the All-Stars are Drew Hanson from Utah and Bennett Davison for Arizona. Drew is a senior majoring in political science. He's got a 3.9 grade point average. And Bennett is a senior majoring in family studies. 17-8, though. A huge surprise in the first half. Utah leading Arizona with 7:57 to go.
Mike Bibby now back in the lineup for Lute Olson's ball club. He's going to have to try to get his game going. Look at that 10-0 run last 4:30. They have stayed in the triangle and two. It has worked. It has become successful. Arizona only 3 of 16 from the field.
Arizona came into this game winners of 23 of their last 24 games after starting the season 7-3.
Again, this is a team that only scored in the 70s 4 times, let alone being in the 60s or anything below that.
Right now, Arizona 3 of 16 from the floor. Inside. Harris picks it up. 18 on the shot clock.
Arizona rattled. They're in a hurry, and the passes are not very good.
Jump hook baseline short. Miller with the rebound. Andre Miller takes it himself. down the leg, kicks it out. And Jensen comes up short. Mike Bibby back into the game, crossover dribble, off the dribble, down it.
What a terrific crossover dribble. That time he didn't worry so much about getting body contact. He's been jumping into guys. That time he put the crossover, the fadeaway, his first two of the ballgame.
One of three shooting, 17-10. Caton stolen away by Terry. He's got Bibby with the great pass and the easy layup.
22nd timeout by Rick Majerus. He understands when he needs them. Great defensive play by Terry. Gives up the basketball. Bibby hits the last two. Terry, the best defender on this squad. Very active hands. Not many people steal balls with the quickness of their hands. Now watch. Out on the floor, the good pass, and Bibby hits two in a row, the All-American. Boy, Caton has to be careful with the ball. Rick Majerus talked about it before the game. We can't have turnovers. Silly passes. We have to be aggressive and hold on to the ball. This is what Arizona wants to do. They can come back in a hurry.
And the turnovers, 4-3, Arizona with 4, Utah with 3. And look at the intensity on the face of Miles Simon. Rather, Mike Bibby.
Lute Olson talks about Mike Bibby and Miles Simon. He doesn't worry about calling timeouts too many times because these two great leaders can run the show, get them into things. Here's a 2-on-1.
Miller, bounce pass, Jackson, easy hoop.
Utah simply threw over the top of the defense.
19-12. Bibby. Short. Miller, another long rebound. Down the lane. Dumps it down. Johnson lays it in.
Utah was slow early, Gus, but they've turned it around. Now they've tried to go into spurts. And Miller, when he has the ball on the break, it's a green light for everybody.
21-12, Utah. 6:17 to go. Terry. Inside. Bramlett lost it. Stole it away. Andre Miller with the hand on it.
When they pop out of the triangle in two, Doliak has to take Terry. They want to get it inside because Miller's guarding Bramlett. Once Bramlett put it on the floor, Miller knocked it away.
Miller posts it up Terry. Left-handed shot won't go. Here's Bibby. 4-on-2. Terry back to Davidson and the easy flush.
They get out and they run. Davison on one end, he finishes on the other.
Bennett Davison, what a great finisher. He's got a 35-inch vertical leap. Senior. 21-14.
Terrific ball game against Maryland. Had 16 points and 7 rebounds.
And a whistle.
Take a look at the pressure. You have 4 Arizona players up front defending. Utah simply threw it over the top. 2-on-1 break. Great assist by Miller.
5:21 to go. Utah leading it 21-14. Game summary. Look at the shooting. 6 of 21 for Arizona. And the points in the paint for Utah, 18-8. That size, a big factor.
Take a look at the defense. Here's your triangle. Here's a man-to-man here, man-to-man here. So really you're going 3-on-3 inside. They're playing a zone. You have to be able to break it down. Mike Dickerson has had some shots. That's an easy attempt. He has just struggled from the field, though, at scoring the ball.
And for Utah this season, no team has shot 50% or better as we look at Virginia Bibby, Mike's mom.
Well, you mentioned that defense of Utah. 4th in the country, only allowing 56 points a game. And 2nd in the country, defensive field goal percentage. Teams only shoot 38% against this team.
Jackson trying to take Bramlett off the dribble. McTavish back in the game. Jackson 20-footer. That's the first outside shot hit by the Utes today. 24-14. Bramlett the other way. Great roll inside.
How quickly they get it back up the floor. But on offensive end, Gus, Utah, much more movement. Crisper passes, trying to break guys off the dribble.
They reverse it. Britton Johnson almost carried the ball. 5 seconds coming up. Finally gets it to McTavish.
and Terry the best on the football defender. Methala. Posted up. He's in. And a whistle and foul inside. Arizona pushed the ball up quickly that time. They got Bibby away from the ball so they could enter it on the side. Brammer with an easy two. He has six on the afternoon.
The foul called on Miles Simon, his second. And Utah holds on. Andre Miller ready to inbound. Jensen, Jackson, Doliak, and Methala in the game for the Utes. Michael Dickerson checks back in. And the stat of the game, field goal percentage. Arizona 7 of 22. Methala wide open. Got it.
Miller, the guy taking it out, surveyed, wasn't in a hurry, found his open man.
26-16, and Terry on the sideline. Six turnovers for Arizona. They only average 14.
Take a look at Andre Miller surveying the floor. That's your point guard. He's patient enough to find someone spotting up. Brammer tried to cheat over, forgot about Methala. 2 points.
Been a perfect first half for the Utes.
Well, look at the spacing. Allows them to cut that lane and try to get some easy baskets.
David Jackson throws it out of bounds. Largest lead of the game for Utah with 4:03 to go in the first half. Six Arizona turnovers. Dickerson leans in. And another air ball, his second of the game. Miller. Bounce pass inside. Methala got it away. But a foul.
Andre Miller really terrific with the basketball. Again, the big size that he has, 6'2", but 200 pounds. When he comes down and surveys the court, he's always looking for teammates.
A.J. Bramlett sits down with three. Explain what's going on for Arizona right now.
They look frustrated. They look totally out of sync on the offensive end. Trying to figure out ways to get shots for their players. Simon's been bottled up. Now he has two fouls. He sits on the bench. Bibby's been bottled up by the triangle in two. The other guys have been standing. And Dickerson's been the guy that has to be able to beat this zone. He's off to a terrible start. 0-5 from the field.
Methala misses the free throw, but Doliak with the offensive rebound and a new shot clock. 26-16. Utah, the number three seed. Arizona, number one. And Doliak travels inside. 3:35 to go in the first half. Utah leading Arizona, 26-16. Armacatea, what do you have?
You know, Gus, one of the things Coach Olson told me is he rarely makes changes on the huddles because both Bibby and Simon are so self-correcting on the court. He says the only thing he often asks players is, during times of toughness like this, in the huddle, are you going to fold? I'm sure that question came up right now.
3:21 to go in the first half. We will see. Odds are Arizona, they will not fold, defending their national championship. 26-16, Bibby. Tipped up and a foul.
A simple ball screen for Mike Bibby, though, freed him up that time, Gus, to be able to get inside the lane. That draws a defense. Now watch how the offensive glass becomes open. Utah is looking at Bibby, and all of a sudden the Wildcats can go to the offensive glass.
And Alex Jensen called for his first foul. Sends Bennett Davis into the line. Davis at 16.7 rebounds. He's a guy that loves to get out on the break and finish strong.
Yeah, high riser, 35-inch vertical jump.
That means at 6'8", if you have a 35-inch vertical, you can probably touch the top of the backboard.
I would think so. So we saw a couple plays on Thursday night. He was up in that vicinity.
Sacramento rattles out. Harris with the rebound to Davison, and he throws it out of bounds.
Surprising that Arizona looks like they're in a hurry. They've struggled shooting, so they're trying to do things so fast. Just have to settle down, play a little more poise.
And the full court pressure not a factor right now for Utah. They almost turned it over. Crowd wanted it over and back. Miller backs it up. Doliak all alone.
Doliak having his way with Davison in the post. He's too big and too strong for Bennett to contain.
28-17. Terry from downtown. Doliak with the rebound. 2:31 to go, a turnover. Bibby to the basket. And a great defensive play by Michael Doliak. Miller. 2:17 to go, 28-17. Jackson. Metcalf gathered himself. Tipped out to Jason Terry. Hayes starting to quicken here in the first half.
They need to give Simon an all the, on the ball screen also.
Terry again. And the shot was contested by Doliak. And when you're 6'11 and you get those hands out there.
Yeah, Terry's only 6'2. The thing about this triangle and two, Terry and Dickerson are the guys who may be open. But if they're not, they act like they're forcing shots because they feel they ought to be open on the first pass. If Doliak comes out, Terry ought to break him down off the dribble.
And Methel has got it.
Michael Doliak has been getting great low post position, and if the offense is patient enough, he'll get himself open on the block.
Doliak with 7 points now coming up at halftime. Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, and Dean Smith will get you updated on the latest tournament news. We'll have a preview of the East Regional Final between UConn and North Carolina. 1:31 remaining in the first half. Utah has surprised everybody in the building. They lead 28-17. Dickerson across the lane. And the baby jumper falls.
And that's the moves he can hit. Dickerson leads his team in scoring. He's explosive. Once the big man went out to contain him, he just put it on the floor to the basket, his first two of the afternoon.
Arizona fans rising to their feet. 28-19. Britton Johnson backs it out.
And take a look how open that lane is to pass and cut.
Under a minute to go. Miller. Ooh, shake and bake to the bucket. And Davison with the board. Bibby got it back. And bodies flying all over the place inside. Whistle and foul against Arizona.
Physical down low. Bibby missed an open one. 2 of 8 on the night. Take a look at the movement down low. Johnson trying to block out. Davison simply just wrestled him to the floor.
Rick Majerus looking for his first Final Four appearance. What a job he's done at Utah.
Yeah, outstanding. He's had some great ball clubs. Last year they lost to Kentucky.
And Rick Johnson got the first free throw to go. 6'9 freshman, McDonald's All-American. Older brother Jeff played for the youth last year. He is now on a Mormon mission.
You know, Johnson, a young man, the fact has had tendonitis in his knee, missed the first 8 ball games, missed all the preseason, but is now starting to warm up. Had 8 points against Arkansas in that big win, had 7 against West Virginia Thursday night in 23 minutes of play.
30 seconds to go, Utah leading it. 29-19, 19 first half points for Arizona.
And as Bibby holds it, that time Majerus is going to try to get the ball out of his hands. They'll double him to make him pass the ball so Mike Bibby can't go one-on-one. Here they come again.
He's calling for the double team.
Trying to take the ball out of Mike Bibby's hands. Rick Majerus calls Bibby the best point guard in the country. And then Rick will say, I have the second best point guard in Andre Miller.
29-19. Dickerson gives it up. Davison to the basket. Cannot finish, but he heads to the line. With 9.2 remaining in the first half, 29-19, Utah leads Arizona.
Well, the surprise part is Arizona has shot 27% from the field. They have only had 2 games all year below 40%. The worst is 38.9, again, the loss to Florida State.
So Davison
block out right here. Block out.
Bleeding and sits down. beat 10-2.
Miles Simon, they can make a substitution, and Simon will come in and shoot the free throw. Simon, about a 79% free throw shooter. As long as a player's hurt, Lute Olson has a chance to take a player and put someone in his place, and Miles Simon is that man.
So Miles Simon at the line with only 1 point in the first half. Had a slow start in the first half against Maryland, but came back in the second half, finished with 18.
Came back when they needed the points. When it got to be a one-point ball game, Simon simply took over. A couple three-pointers, a couple floating mid-range jump shots.
And the first free throw is good.
Maybe the most confident of all players in college basketball, Miles Simon. The key for Simon, though, Gus, right here, he has two fouls. Don't pick up your third in the last 9 seconds of this first half.
Second one short. Doliak comes up with the rebound. Michael Doliak, 6 rebounds in the first half. Miller, 4 to go. Inside the runner. And that's it. But the Utah Utes are sitting in the position they want to be in.
Great defensive first half by Rick Majerus. They have Arizona guessing at what they're going to do when they come out for the second half.
Arizona's first half season low in scoring, 30 points. They head into the locker room with only 20. Here's Armakatayan.
Ricky, can't ask for much better than this on both ends of the floor.
Well, our kids are playing their heart out. We're taking good care of the ball. We got great shot selection. That's only half a game, though. That's 20 minutes. There's 20 minutes more to play, and we've got to maintain our intensity and take better care of the ball.
Thanks, Rick. Back to you, Gus.
All right, Armin. That's the end of the first half with the score, 29-20, Utah leading Arizona. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Switch either triangle and two and try a box and one or a different zone or a man-to-man. Surprise the Wildcats, because I'm sure Lute Olson, they talked about it at halftime.
And the 30 points versus Illinois State in the first half was the lowest this season until this game. And it's easy to say Arizona, their worst first half this season.
And Arizona in that game against Illinois State scored 52 the second half.
Jensen to Doliak on the perimeter. Metella off the dribble, gathers himself. Davison with the ball. Hibby almost doubled.
He wanted to throw the lob to Dickerson.
Hibby inside. Dickerson, 1 of 6 in the first half. Make it 1 of 7.
And he's getting the shot that he wants and the coaching staff wants. That time they put a pass.
Somehow he was all alone.
Well, he outran everybody. Nobody turned around to help out Davison.
He has 6 points. 31-20. Arizona, a team that averages 91 points per game.
Somebody give Simon or Vivian on the ball screen.
Bramlett. He's fouled.
Andre Miller head up, eyes up, and Metella gets by everybody. He outruns Davison, but surprisingly, none of the Wildcats picked him up. Always have to recognize where the ball is.
Doliak picks up his first. Their last meeting right here at the Anaheim Pond. Arizona overcame an 11-point deficit and came back to win it.
That ball game, they had a 20-3 run in the second half. And Rick Majerus said, basically, we weren't able to handle that then, but I think our players are more mature now. Minus one, Keith Van Horn from a year ago.
Andre Miller also saying that he was a bit out of shape and not ready to handle a great guard from Arizona. They took advantage of it.
Arizona was 3 of 6 from the foul line, Gus, in the first half. They averaged almost 24 free throw attempts a ball game. It's only 6 attempts that first half.
10-point lead for the Utes. Opening moments of the second half. The winner moves on to San Antonio. The final four. Miller Metalon. Got it.
Good screen by Doliak to free up Miller. Then made a good pass cross court.
Bibby around the screen, and he's fouled by Drew Hanson.
See more movement of the Wildcats on the offensive end.
Well, that is Drew's third foul. Bibby with the inbound pass. Simon, only 1 point in the first half. Back to Bramlett, drop step, great play.
Bramlett simply reestablished himself in the low block. Give Miles Simon credit for being patient enough to wait for his man, big man, to get set.
He has 9. 33-23, and Bibby trying to come up with the steal. Knocks it out of bounds.
Rick Majerus has put in a plan on their early offense. They have 4 players on the outside, and they put Doliak in the inside. Gives Doliak much more freedom to work, try to establish himself in the low post.
Double team it on the sideline. Hanson dribbles out of it to Miller. Kicks it out. Dickerson trying to find his stroke, and this time he does. For 2.
And Dickerson has been able in some games this year to have big second halves. At UCLA, when they were down most of that ball game by as many as 14 points, Dickerson ended up with 22 that second half, 30 on the ball game.
Here comes the press. Metalo backs it up and finds a guard.
Easily handled, but Arizona only had 3 guys up front and not 4. Had 2 men back defensively.
Jensen on the wing. Miller knocked away by Mike Bibby.
Rick Majerus' ball club is making the Wildcats play defense for lots of periods of time on the defensive end. They're making hard cuts.
And they turn it over on the baseline. Miller stepping on the baseline. 8th turnover of the game for Utah.
Take a look as he wants to throw it in. Had nobody there. Arizona had sealed all the avenues.
8 turnovers for the Utes, 7 for Arizona. Davison inbounding with Bibby, Simon, and Dickerson in the backcourt. Bramlett and Davison in the front court.
Still in the triangle on 2.
Davison. Andre Miller with the rebound. Weaving his way down the court. Inside, tipped in by Metalla. He's having a big game.
Great ball game.
Dickerson the other way, rejected by Miller. On both ends of the floor. Down the lane. And a foul.
Andre Miller doing it all. Goes to the hole. Look at the attention he draws. 3 white shirts. It allows Metalla to sneak inside. Now Miller gets back defensively. Remember, he was on the offensive end. He beats everybody down back defensively. He makes a block on Dickerson.
Andre Miller out of Burbham Day High School in Los Angeles. Some great players coming out of there. David Greenwood, Roy Hamilton, and now Miller. And he is a Proposition 48 student, but is scheduled to graduate in 4 years. So for the second year, they've listed him as a junior. He can come back next year and play. Doliak, rebound and stick back.
Simply took the ball away from Davison.
Right now, Utah wants it more. 38-25, Bibby. The ball just not dropping for the Wildcats.
And 1 shot and out for Arizona. Utah, the best rebounding team in college basketball.
And the Utes come back and remain patient on offense. Inside, Jensen.
This is a clinic on the offensive end.
They look like Princeton.
Yeah, they're passing, they're cutting, sharing the basketball. Arizona's confused.
Dickerson. Bibby, quick shot. Bramlett lost it, picked up gets to Miller. The other way, straight to the hole. They have Arizona scrambling. Intention wide open inside. Andre Miller, you talk about confidence. This is 1-on-4. He decides that he can get in there with his strength. Almost knocks it in. His coach said that the guy he's checking today, Mike Bibby, is the best point guard. But Andre is making a case, 9 points, 9 rebounds. He may have a chat with the coach after this game if they're successful. Ramlett fouled Miller, and he picks up his fourth foul. Andre Miller, second one is good. Surprise, surprise. 41-25. Utah on an 8-0 run in the last 2:58, and they have opened up a 16-point lead.
Arizona only 2 of 7 from the field the second half, while Utah 5 of 8, getting better shots. They've had 10 layups in this ballgame versus 1 for the Wildcats.
But you know one thing is for sure, Arizona will make a run.
Well, obviously not national champs for a reason. There's the big switch out. Now you have to dump it inside. They missed. It goes down low.
Perry, tough shot inside.
And now here comes a full court pressure.
Doliak. Hanson.
Handled once again.
And Utah, they've seen two great presses in the NCAAs, Arkansas and West Virginia. Metcalf, the finger roll.
Once you jam him, Metcalf, capable of putting it on the floor. We've seen that 3 times already in the ballgame. Straight to the rim.
He's 6'10 with guard skills. Simon. Here comes Miller. Down the lane. Great no-look pass. They're running, gunning, and fronting right now. The Utes on top, 45-27.
And Simon and Bibby, Gus, look tired because they're doing so much movement on the offensive end but can't find an opening.
Simon.
Oh!
And he got it to go. 13:53 to go. 45-29. Offensive foul. And it's waved off.
They're going to call Jason Terry with a push from behind. Take a look at Terry behind. Does he give him a little shove with the elbow, the forearm?
That's an offensive foul.
Boy, that was hard to see the push, but it was called from the opposite end. Rude Olson did not agree with that one.
Metcalf, 45-29. Metcalf again dribbling. Cut off this time.
Metcalf looks like a totally different player than we saw Thursday evening.
Bounce fast inside. Off of a foot. Taken away by Bramley. Simon. Crossover, baseline. He's fouled.
Simon simply saying that Alex Jensen cannot guard me. And the man-to-man triangle, too, no matter who matches up, Simon's just simply going to try to take Jensen off the dribble. Well, Michael Doliak and Bramlett have gone at each other all afternoon. Doliak's a big target to throw to. Sometimes the ball moves and he can't quite get position because Bramlett's still working hard.
Jensen is second foul. Doliak sits down. Third team foul against Utah. 13-16 to go in the second half.
And fresh bodies in by Rick Majerus to contain Simon and Bibby once again.
Bramlett posted up. It's backside. Terry wide open. Davison a rebound. And a foul inside. Ball just not going in the jar today.
Yeah, Davison missed a gimme. He set a great pick to free up Terry. It went weak side, and as the rebound came off, here's the miss. Davison had set a great screen. Terry gets an open look at this. Right there, point blank, can't get it in the hole.
Arizona 12 of 41 from the field, 29%. Folks, they're 1 of 11 from the three-point line. And it's that kind of shooting day for the Wildcats.
And that one looked pretty tight.
Second free throw is good. 45 to 30. 13:05 to go. Here's a full court press. Chase Caton breaks to the ball.
If they can get it over the top, remember, Johnson very good with the ball. Turnover.
10th turnover of the game for the Utes. So Hansen back in, and Caton steps up.
Hansen matches up with Miles Simon. Jackson will take care of Bibby. The other three, three-man zone. Triangle.
And a lot of body contact on the low post. Foul called against the Utes.
Take a look at Miller trying to fight A.J. Bramlett downside in the post area. Gives up about 9 inches in height.
His second foul, Doliak back in. Jackson sits down. Miles Simon inside, jump hook, got it back. Let it go, and he's fouled.
We talked about the confidence that Miles Simon played with. One of the toughest competitors of all of college basketball also. He has decided it's time for him to take charge. Misses the first one going up, but watch him snatch the rebound. Strong again, but was fouled on the arm.
Jensen's third. Al Simon first. In and out. 5 of 11. For Arizona from the free throw line.
And the Wildcats are now starting to get to the line, Gus, but they're not making their foul shots.
Second one rims off. Zona 72% from the line on the season. 45 to 30.
You miss free throws, you put a lot of pressure on your defense.
Andre Miller had it blocked from behind. Michael Beebe in transition. Simon around the screen, knocked away. Great looking play by Alex Jensen. Refused to be beaten back door. 8 turnovers for Arizona.
Utah hasn't scored in a while, but they haven't had to. Arizona not getting the ball in the basket themselves.
Jensen on the baseline, met the line. What a game he's having. 14 points, 47 to 30. For three, partially blocked, it's short. Terry, it still won't go down. And finally, snatched down by Dolia.
1 of 13, and Miles Simon's legs look tired.
And panic starting to set in on the faces of the Arizona Wildcats. Dolia for three, Simon with the rebound. 28% shooting for Zona. Terry again, and finally knocks it in.
Well, he won't be bashful. He's a scorer, and the pressure's still on, but Utah handles it easily again.
Miller. Oh, what a big basket. Drew Hansen strokes it. The senior from Poole, Utah. 50-33. Timeout called by the Wildcats.
22nd timeout. Lute Olson not happy with the on the defensive end. Utah scored a layup last time and a wide open three-pointer then by Hansen. They're not challenging anybody on their shots. They look a little bit leg heavy. They look tired. They're spending a lot of energy on the offensive end trying to get open for shots, but they're not converting.
The tournament summary, Kentucky, they looked sensational last night against UCLA, advances to the Elite Eight for the sixth time in 7 years. Duke reaches the Elite Eight as they defeated Syracuse. But right now, Coach Olsen's team in a lot of trouble with 10:47 to go. And look at the points in the paint.
Patient on the offensive end, making the Wildcats play defense for about 25 seconds almost on every possession.
Mike Bibby pushes off in the corner. Dickerson, 15-foot fadeaway. Knocked out of bounds by the Wildcats. 10:37 to go in the second half, 50-33 Utah. 50-33, Utah leading Arizona, 10:37 remaining in the second half, 10:37 standing in the way of the Utes and the Final Four.
Well, they've done the things they wanted to defensively, and offensively they've shot about 49%. Their execution has been brilliant. The pressure has not bothered them yet.
Rick Johnson, the freshman, trying to get it over the line, and he does.
Boy, that was a 10-second count.
Must have been 9.5. Jensen.
Now you keep your spacing, keep the ball movement, and search for Doliak as he moves inside.
Jackson for three. He bounded inside by Davison. See if Arizona can go on a run here. Dickerson. Davison. Look backside, Bramlett, up and above.
Good foul by Jensen. A.J. Bramlett has an easy two. Frustrated by the rotation in himself, but that's a good foul. Put Bramlett on the free throw line.
Arizona 5 of 12 from the line today. A.J. Bramlett. One of two. Bramlett missing the first one.
Boy, 2 of 7 this second half from the foul line. It has been a struggle for this Wildcat team.
Michael Doliak sits down. He's got 9 points and 10 rebounds.
Rick Majerus continues to rotate bodies in and out.
Second one good for Bramlett. And they get into the full court press. Bibby sits down for a quick blow. And Simon back in. Ball knocked out of bounds by Terry.
Gus, the thing about this pressure, Utah, they have such tall bodies. They become more visible when you're searching for a guy to throw it to. You can throw it up high. They've got a guy like Johnson, who's 6'9", he can handle the ball through it. It's in Miller's hands. They're real confident with the ball.
Over the line, Johnson, Metala.
Again, look how open the basket area is when they make cuts.
Johnson to the hole, and he's fouled by Davison. But you just talked about it. Brent Johnson can get to the basket.
He can put it on the floor. This freshman is terrific with the ball, and Davison allows him to go by. That looks like a pretty clean block. But again, the basket area wide open. No help from any weak side Arizona players. Utah taking advantage.
And Johnson gets the first one to go. He missed 8 weeks with patella tendonitis in his left knee. A McDonald's All-American. Second one is short. Rebounded by Davison. 51-34, under 10 to go. Terry lost an edge inside. Dickerson, nice look.
That's what they should do off the dribble. Make Utah collapse in the middle and help out.
Miller double team, cross court, Hanson. drives baseline, bobbled up in a block and foul against Terry.
We've seen Michael Dickerson, the whole ball. He loves to go to his right hand. You need to force him to his left because he's explosive that way. The dump off, the easy finish by Davison. The easiest they've had all ball game. Good pass, good finish.
Fifth team foul against Arizona. Second on Terry. And Doliak returns. Britton Johnson. Methala sits down. Britt Johnson, Jensen, Hanson, Doliak, and Miller on the court for Utah.
Spacing, body movement, ball movement.
Offensive foul against Miller.
Jason Terry in. Boy, you're allowed to step.
Third foul on Andre Miller, 51-36. So if you're Arizona, with this deficit, how do you attack it?
Well, they've attacked it all right. They just haven't made shots. You continue to miss, you're not going to win the ballgame.
Where do you want to be, though, at what time on the clock to make a run back?
Well, you'd like to start it now. 8:30 left in the ballgame, and Utah has to continue to play to win and not to lose at this point. Good save, good play by Miller. Rick Majerus's ball club still wants to take opportunities, Gus, but you still spread the floor out. This was an early shot, not probably a good one. Spread the floor out, keep moving, use Doliak in the inside, make this Wildcat team play defense, because that is wearing them down. As the defense wears down, if the basket area becomes open, it's an advantage to the offensive player like that. Defender gets tired, the legs get sore. Miller takes it right off the dribble.
12 points for Andre Miller, 53-36 Utah. Dickerson on the baseline.
And Utah is as tired on the defensive end, Gus, but Arizona hasn't made any shots against him.
Dickerson. Let it go. Inside, out of bounds. Utah ball. So the Utes taking it strong to the basket. 7:39 away from San Antonio. And welcome back to game summary, 53-36 the score. The field goal shooting for Arizona, 29%, 48% shooting for Utah. That's been the huge difference. And Arizona, 2 of 15 from the three-point line.
And the points in the paint, the bottom line is Utah has run effective offensively. Arizona's wearing down with their legs. Then they use you to take it off the dribble or pass it inside. They're getting good looks right at the rim.
Michael Doliak with 9 points. And the ball kicked out of bounds. There's the father of Michael Doliak, Bill Doliak. Hanson. Up top, Jackson. Doliak, great catch to save it from going out of bounds.
He has the best hands of any big man in college ball.
It's like a shortstop scooping that one up. Miller off the dribble again to the bucket, and a finger roll is good.
Time and time again, this Ute team, especially Miller, has been able to break down the defense just by the dribble.
14 points for Miller, along with 9 rebounds. Inside, Bramlett blocked. Picked up by Miller. The push. And a foul. Terry again.
Frustration has set in now for the Wildcats. They're playing solid defense, but look at the weak side help. It's not there. Miller gets all the way. It's late. Bramlett's late. Davison is late. He beats Terry off the dribble. Now Terry trying to contain him, and there's the blocking, and Andre Miller has just taken charge of this ballgame.
The Arizona Wildcats, the defending national champions, trying to become the first team since Duke in 91 and 92 to repeat. But they have a mountain to climb with 6:49 to go, down 55-36. Live pass, Doliak got it back.
And when you're ahead, you have much more energy, Gus, than when you're down on the scoreboard.
So Michael Doliak at the line to complete the three-point play, and he does. Utah. They're high-fiving in the stands right now, 6:40 away from a trip to the Final Four.
And Lute Olson has gone to the smallest lineup he can put on the floor. Bibby, Terry, Simon, got Bramlett inside, and also Dickerson on the outside. A four-guard offense.
Simon, baseline. Up, block from behind, and he's fouled.
They're trying to draw Doliak away from the hoop. Penetration. Watch Hansen with the reach. Drew did not like that call.
Fourth foul on Drew Hansen. Miles Simon, 2 of 10 from the... making 1 of 7 from the field, 3 of 7 from the free throw line. 5 points today, 17 on the season. Second is good.
It's so difficult to get back in this ball game because of the spacing Utah has had both against the press and in their half-court offense.
And a 5-second count against the Utes. That's the freshman, Britton Johnson, inbounding the ball. Dickerson, Terry for three. Got it.
Here they come.
Let's see. Johnson again, confused. Miller spins out of it. Nice look. Doliak flushes. And here they come. 60-41. Dickerson, baseline, and he's fouled.
The key, Andre Miller frees himself up to spin, and now it's simply 2-on-1. Let the defense come to you, then make the pass an easy finish. Again, the good catch, but the pass right on the money.
Dickerson at the line. And Andre Miller, his coach said Mike Bibby was the best point guard in the country. He has answered, folks, with a triple-double. 14 points, 12 rebounds, and 11 assists.
Well, how valuable he was in that win against Arkansas. All the pressure he handled with 3 turnovers. He had 28 points and 7 rebounds. They want it in his hands.
60-43. Utes, 6:03 to go. Dangerous pass, but Miller was there. No looker, Jensen! And he got the ball! It's all falling in for Utah. They're shooting 52%. Terry crossover. But it won't go down for Arizona. .44-18 points in the paint.
Make the Wildcats play defense. Wear their legs down, then when you want to make a hard cut, you make it the basket area. Keep it free.
Miller, a whistle.
This is what George Karl, they were working on last night. Get Doliak up, throw it over the top so that Miller has the ball at the free throw line. Then the break, 2-on-1. Let your point guard make the decision at the end, and he has been right on target all afternoon.
And after the game on Thursday night, we saw George Karl and Coach Majerus at dinner, and you should have seen the two of them talking. I mean, it was the most intense dinner conversation I've seen. Majerus had a notebook, and he must have had 50 plays in that notebook, all given to him by George Karl, or they were discussing them together.
And Rick Majerus said, I'm going to go home and watch video till about 4:30 in the morning, then get about 3 or 4 hours of sleep and back up, watch it again. What a game plan he has prepared for his team, and the players have executed, Gus. Defensively, the triangle two has confused this Wildcat team and worn out Bibby and Simon on the offensive end.
And speaking of worn out, Andre Miller is wearing out Arizona 64-43. Andre with 16 points, 11 rebounds, and 12 assists. Simon, and another rebound by Miller.
The issue's being forced now by Arizona.
Miller again down the lane.
Gus Miller won't back off.
No, sir.
He is not playing to lose. He is playing to win.
Jason Terry, though, with the three. Under 5 minutes remaining.
Boy, Arizona looks tired. Their hands are on their hips.
Miller lobs it into the front court. Hanson. And they get it back to their pressure guy, Andre Miller.
And Utah, very good when they have leads. They shoot nearly 74% from the foul line. Protect the ball, no turnover. Make Arizona chase.
Jackson inside. Bibby, quick release. And it's picked up by Terry. Mike Bibby, 2 of 11 in the corner. 2 of 12. And another rebound, Andre Miller.
Well, we have some tired bodies. Drew Hanson wants out of this ball game. Jensen is tired. Their defense has been outstanding. They need a break. Look at Andre Miller. Can barely keep himself up. Can barely keep himself up as he goes to the sideline. But Andre Miller has made great decisions in the open court with the basketball. This one in traffic, the little floater, the touch over the rim.
Don't forget, coming up, UConn and North Carolina in Greensboro, the number one seed against the number two seed. Rip Hamilton and company with a dramatic win over Washington at the buzzer. Can they keep it going against North Carolina?
Can they get their energy going against North Carolina? Carter Jamison outstanding. Shimon Williams just shooting lights out, so Jim Calhoun has to be ready.
4 minutes to go, 66-46 Utah.
A Utah team that does not make many mistakes when they have the basketball. Solid passer.
Goliak steps out, showing the range, and he got it. What can he do? Catch. Rebound, shoot, jump shot, 16 points. Goliak commits the foul on the baseline. Rick Majerus has never advanced to the Final Four. Last year, they were taken care of in the West Regional Championship by Kentucky 72-59 in San Jose.
Ron Mercer put on a show that ball game, had 21. Lost to Kentucky the year before in the Sweet 16. Boy, what a struggle it's been for Arizona at the foul line. Only 10 of 19.
The Wildcats, after winning the national championship in Indianapolis last year, the favorites to repeat. They had everybody coming back.
After starting 7-3 this season, they won 19 games in a row, 21 of their last 22, but this Utah squad had a strategy and it has worked so far.
Jackson.
Good decision.
And they continue to melt the clock.
And make the Wildcats chase and wear down, and you'll get good shots.
Jackson inside! And I think the Utah Utes have broken the spirit of this Arizona squad, 70-46. Simon lost it. And Jensen with the board.
Wildcats are dead tired. Jason Terry grabbing his shorts. Bibby grabbing his shirt. What a performance by Andre Miller, Mike Doliak, and the rest of this Heat squad. Now it's simply keep away. Again, you will shoot layups and free throws. Andre Miller, 18 points. This is his 13th assist. The easy pass, nobody there defensively. Take a look at the excitement. Raise the roof, says Hal Metola. Boy, look how tired Andre Miller is.
And there's Andre Miller's mom. Andrea Robinson looking on.
Look at the smile.
Follows her son wherever they play in the NCAAs. Rode a bus to Dallas last year to see him play. And the smiles on the Utah bench and the sadness on the bench of Arizona. Second free throw good. 2:34 to go in the second. Utah on top, 72-46. The Alamo Dome in San Antonio. This is where the Utes are trying to get as they look to become the first team to advance to the Final Four. And with 2 minutes and 34 seconds remaining, Rick Majerus is trying to guide this Utah team into the Final Four for the first time since 1966. Mike Bibby, Terry, quick three. And Doliak with the rebound.
And again, one shot and out this Utah team.
Jackson in the front court. Wisely backs it out and milks the clock.
Good decision. Get in Miller's hands. Now play keep away. And Doliak is one of the best free throw shooters. He's a great big man. You throw it up high, he can catch it. He loves to get fouled.
Don't forget, coming up, North Carolina, the number one seed in the East against UConn, seeded number two. 6 o'clock Eastern time. 2:11 remaining. And David Jackson, the sophomore from Portland, Oregon, at the line. Rick Majerus. There's been talk about this being his last season at Utah, playing with 10 freshmen and sophomores. They've mentioned Arizona State as a possible site for Coach Majerus. And the statistic of the game, field goal percentage, Arizona, 28%, 54% shooting for Utah. Coach Olson told Armin Katayan they needed to start hitting shots, have not been able to do it.
And this is the third most offensive team in the country at 82 points a ball game. And they're sitting at 47 with 2 minutes left. It's amazing. Did not shoot the ball well. We talked about they've only had two games under 40% all year. They've only had eight under 45%.
Don't forget, once again, coming up next, North Carolina and UConn. So what does this do with Utah advancing to the Final Four? A lot of people thought that Arizona was the favorite to repeat with Utah in there.
Seems to throw a lot of wrinkles in all the brackets that everybody filled out, Gus. But Utah brings size, they bring discipline, they're an outstanding rebounding unit. They play great man-to-man defense today. We saw a triangle in two, but what they do well. They know what they don't do well. They stay away from a lot of things, but they've handled pressure well from every team in this tournament. They've rebounded well. They've put the ball in the hands of Miller and Doliak, their stars, and they've delivered for them.
Mike Bibby, 75-49, and a 20-second timeout called by Lou Olson.
They often talk about guards, and there's Andre Miller. How valuable it is in a triple-double, 18 points, 14 rebounds, and 13 assists. You have a lead guard that can do that and break people down. He's 6'2", about 200 pounds. He's physical enough and strong enough to do those things. You have a center like Michael Doliak at 6'11", that plays inside. He goes outside, knocks in free throws. Well-coached ball club. They have been outstanding today. Just a great game plan, and they all executed it well.
Now tomorrow in the Midwest region, Rhode Island, who took care of Valpo, takes on Stanford. Those two teams have met before. A one-point win for the Cardinal. Into the front court, Hansen. Then there is Duke and Kentucky as well.
And Kentucky has had average victories by over 21 points in the NCAA tournament.
In the South, Duke and Kentucky, Duke beating Syracuse. And I don't think there's a team playing better basketball in the country right now than the Kentucky Wildcats under Tubby Smith.
And it's been Kentucky's depth that's wore people down. But Duke has enough bodies, and their freshmen were outstanding last night. Battier, Brand, and Avery, terrific last night. They have enough depth. We'll see. That should be a terrific matchup.
Miles Simon, what a great college career the senior has had. MVP of the Final Four last year. And Miles Simon checks out of the game. And a standing ovation given to Simon by the Arizona fans. There's his dad, Walt. Bramlett comes out. Dickerson also comes out. Lute Olson, allowing some of the substitutes to get an opportunity to play.
Well, Miles Simon and Michael Dickerson both had their uniforms retired on senior night. Tough way to end, but they won a national championship a year ago, had a great run this season. Over 500 points, Dickerson, Simon, and Bibby. The last time that was done was Sean Elliott, Tolbert, and Anthony Cook. Tough afternoon, though.
1:38 to go. Utah 76, Arizona 49. And another rebound. Andre Miller foul. Coming up on the road to the Final Four show, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, and Deep Smith will preview and analyze the East Regional Final between Connecticut and North Carolina. Plus, we'll have post-game celebration and interviews from this game. That's coming up on the road to the Final Four. And the East Regional. North Carolina, the number one seed, against Connecticut, the number two seed. 6 o'clock, that game tips off. Andre Miller, what a story. Proposition 48. And Miller said that the only team that recruited him, the only team that stayed with him, was Utah. Jensen checking out of the game. Asked if the Wildcats recruited him, he said no. Coach Majera stuck with me. And now he's graduating in 4 years and has an additional year to play.
And what a ball game this afternoon. This Utah team, outstanding coaching by Rick Majerus, a triangle in two, but the work by Miller and defensively by Hansen and Jensen to chase Simon, to chase Bibby all around all game long, to give yourself up, to sacrifice, go through the screens and do all that. They wore down the quicker Arizona Utah.
Second one is good. Coming up next, it's North Carolina and UConn in the East, tipping off at 6 o'clock. 1 minute, 22 seconds to go here. 76-51. Arizona will not foul anymore. Methala over the line, and he's had a sensational game for the Utes.
Yeah, they were tentative. We talked about it Thursday night against West Virginia. They were tentative ball club. They didn't shoot well, except Doliak was the only aggressive one. Andre Miller a little bit, but everybody came ready to play this afternoon. And they are heading to San Antonio.
Miller, the star of this game, along with this man, Doliak, pulling up. 45 to go. Bibby, Metsola with the rebound. The Utah Utes out of the way. The third seed have pulled off the upset over number one seeded Arizona.
They lost Keith Van Horn. How many people thought they would be here today?
Only three losses for the Utes this year. New Mexico, Wyoming, and UNLV, and their season continues. 6 seconds to go. .9 remaining. And that is it. The Utah Utes are headed for San Antonio, the Final Four for the first time since 1966. Great season has come to an end for Arizona. Here's Armin Katayan.
Coach Olsen, a great two-year run, but it ended today.
Yeah, it did. We got beat every way you could get beat. Got beat when they had free throws, they knocked them down. When they had looks, they knocked them down. I thought we got great looks all day long, and you've got to make shots. They handled the pressure, I thought, very well. Hurt us on the pressure, but yet the way things were going, we really didn't have much choice other than to try to get the tempo picked up. Utah played great though. On this day, if we shoot the ball the way we shot it, obviously,
thanks.
What they did helped too.
Thank you very much. Back to you, Gus.
The final score, 76 to 51. Utah advances to the Final Four, knocking off the top-seeded Arizona Wildcats. And the Chevrolet most valuable players of the game, Andre Miller, a triple-double. And Jason Terry, 16 points for Arizona. So Utah heads for San Antonio. They're the first. Greg Gumbel will join you from New York after this. And Dick Cartmill, Reichling, the lead official. Richard Hamilton has had a sensational tournament for UConn. Khalid El Amin has averaged 23 points per game in the NCAA tournament. Hamilton and El Amin are the two leading scorers in the entire tournament. They've been the major focus for Connecticut. Bill Guthridge says they're much more than a two-man team. The other players don't get much attention, but they're quality role players.
Well, he's impressed with Bostil up front. Of course, Ricky Moore, great defender, but what a lead guard, Khalid El Amin. He's fun to watch.
Connecticut and